Hey y'all, welcome to my channel. My name is D. Colin. If you've never been here before, welcome. If you are returning, welcome and thank you for coming back. I have another vlog for y'all. It's been a while. I wanted to have this out already, but we're here now. So this vlog is about an exhibit that I had at Schenectady High School. It's actually the first time I've ever had a solo exhibit that I didn't curate myself. Like, I didn't go out and get the space and do all the logistical things to put on a show. This was someone asking me to show my work and then curating how it looks in the space, and doing all I had to do was just give my work. And so this was a great experience for me because of that, because I've never had that experience before. I've had pieces in shows, like individual pieces, but not a whole show where it's just my work. So that was cool. It's cool that I got to like combine older pieces and newer pieces to make this show. And the show's over now, but I wanted y'all to be able to see some snippets from the show and what it looked like. And it's also given me some ideas for the show that I'm currently working on. I have a show that I was supposed to have done for April, the first weekend in April, but I've had to postpone that show. And I guess I'll talk about that more in another vlog. But this show was cool to see young people reacting and interacting with the work. And hearing what they liked and asking me questions about how I like painted hair on the canvas, and you know, what was my technique. So that was a cool experience to kind of see the young people interacting with my work and asking me questions. And I really enjoyed myself in that regard. So I hope that you enjoy this video, and I will see you in the next one. Don't forget to like and subscribe.
Especially in our school, which is like really diverse and stuff. Like, I think it's very important to have artwork like this, like in this space, you know? Because like, you don't really see a lot of works like this usually, and I think it's really important to have this here, you know?
Okay. Are you an artist yourself? What kind of art do you do?
I paint, and like, I do a lot of things.
Okay. You speak with the artist?
Yeah.
What'd you ask her?
I asked her about like certain techniques she used with the pieces and whatnot.
Okay. And what's your favorite piece in here?
I think the one back there with the frill with like the words on it, like the gold one back there.
I love the pieces, of course, and I love like the people in the pictures, like all the one with the afros and everything, because I have afro myself. And I especially love One Piece with the fabric because it gives like a home vibe and stuff. So that's what I like about them.
Are you an artist yourself?
Sort of. So, I'm a dancer.
Yeah,
so
that's art.
Yeah, so I'm a hip hop artist.
Okay. What's your favorite piece on YouTube?
I like two. So number, I don't know what number it is. I can see. But I don't know what number. But the one down there, Shakedown, that's my favorite one. I love that one.
The one with Erykah Badu?
Yeah.
Okay. And what's your second favorite one you said?
The one in the middle.
Okay. I like it.
I love those two.
What do you like about those pieces?
I like the one down there because, I don't know, it just makes your afro look really pretty and stuff. And I know I have a pretty afro too. So I don't know, it just reminded me of myself and stuff. And the one in the middle, I don't know. It just, I think it looks really calming and like just how like she made it and everything with the fabric and the back and everything, it makes it like, feel like I could just take it home and lay down with it. Like, that's why I like this.
Okay.
One, I've been interested in her work. I've seen her, the buzz, some of the murals she did from downtown Troy, and I haven't shown a lot of work like hers in the gallery. So about a year ago, when I was doing, I was kind of working a year in advance with the gallery when I was starting to say, okay, what kind of artist am I going to get in here? I contacted her, and then when I looked at the schedule, I thought it'd be a great time, February, Black History Month, put in someone that would represent, have a similar voice to a lot of my students. Mm-hmm. So far, it has actually been very like positive too, because I have a lot of students. So even like when you gallery's closed, you can walk by and see it, and a lot of kids have asked me questions about the bases. So it's one of the reasons to get like a voice of her, like hers, artwork like that for kids to see it. I'm always trying to like stay diverse, have different people, you know. A lot of the students I teach are very interested in the arts, so I like to foster and keep them knowing that there are so many careers in arts, that there's lots of ways that you can make a living in arts, and a lot of kids, that's their voice, you know, that's like something that they can excel in, that they can be, they can express themselves with. So this is, let's see, one, two, three, the fifth show of the season. And they've all been very different. The last show was like the faculty art show, so that was very different. The other show before that was a solo show by a local artist, and then I had another group show with Barry artists. And there's something always in every show that the kids like, you know, whether, and it's always stuff a lot of times. It's not always my favorites, you know, because I curate the shows and I put them together. It's always something, everybody has like something different. So like in this show, a lot of kids responded to the big pieces. And I, you know, also placement, but like the big pieces, that piece a lot of pieces in here. Last show, a lot of the students were responding to a lot of nature pieces, a lot of the paintings. And then I think, I think the kids really like big paintings, things that like show, like that they can like kind of look at and think about and like wonder, like why did you paint this? What's going on? Because the painting, the work before that, there was a lot of very narrative. There was like kind of things you had to figure out. The ones that were the more narrative ones, the ones that were like pictures, they had to figure out that's what they were really gravitating to. Why did they do that? Why are there holes over there? Who's that over there? So things that they can really look and investigate is, I think, what they really like.